أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون. صدق الله العظيم.
Jazakallah khair, Brother Ahmed, mashallah. Beautiful recitation. And just to give more barakah to the gathering, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us always in on the Quran, around the Quran, reflecting and pondering and worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that any gathering around the Quran is surrounded by angels, guaranteed the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the tranquility will come down on us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. And we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the Quran, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Tamla al-mizan. It fills our record with good deed. On Thursday, some of us went and visited somebody's house. We went, and when we arrived in the area where he lives, we said, anybody, any human being would say, oh my God, this beautiful area, wide streets, big flash houses, high fences, big gates. And you straight away you say to yourself, I wish I live in this area, not in Naina, not in Taika, not in Newton, not in Dabarani. Shaitan comes and says, I want to live in this area, why not me? When you arrive into the house you're visiting and you find the gates and the big house with so many rooms, so, you know, just 7-8 rooms. And you say to yourself, wow, I wish I have this, you know, rooms and house, flash house, leather seats, white, different colors. Then you see the man and he tells you about his sons who study in medicine in the International School of Medicine in Malaysia, the National School of Medicine in Brisbane, you know, going to England to have this PhD, the children. And you say to yourself, wow, I wish my children will do the same like this. And then you realize and you find out that the man you're talking to, he got cancer in the lungs. That every breath he takes is painful. Every breath he takes, he thinks it's the last one. Every breath he takes, he thinks he's going to die next. And then you talk to yourself and say, wallahi, we are so ignorant, so ungrateful to what Allah is giving us. Allah give us health and happiness and, you know, happy life, full fridges, full cupboard, full tummy, lots of respect from everybody, no fear of, no pain. And we're still telling Allah, no, I don't like your choice. I want this house. I want the street. I want the neighborhood. I want the car. I want the children. And if we know what this man has, we will never ever ask for what they have. We will never ever, because it's a whole package. It's a package. Do you want the house and the cars and the children and cancel the lands? You don't want it. Do you want the house and the children and this and that, and you lose respect of everybody? So, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We need to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, because He is praiseworthy before our existence. It's not our praise that increases Him in power or anything. It only increases us in honor. And the surah we are reflecting on, it is the surah of etiquette, the surah of adab, the surah of values, the surah of manners, of how to deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then how to deal with the Prophet, and how to deal with the believer, and how to deal with the bad believer, and how to deal with mankind. In 18 lines, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us at the beginning, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, an honor for us. Wallahi, it's honor for us, for Allah to call on us and say, oh, you who believe. It's an honor for humanity, actually. To the whole of humanity, that we are witness that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is a messenger. It's an honor to all mankind that we being called on, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. So when Allah is calling us with the best titles, He's teaching us a lesson to call each other also with the best titles. Yeah? Allah is not saying, you're ignorant, who don't know nothing, come, I'll teach you. No. All you who are violent and aggressive, no. All who are tempered, no. He tells us, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Call on us, all you who believe. Believe in what? Look at the beauty of Islam and the beauty of the Quran. It never says believe in what? Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. All you who believe. And it carries on giving instruction. Believe in what? They believe in Allah, His messengers, the angels, the book, the day of judgment. Yeah? Why doesn't it mention it? Why? Because He doesn't want to exhaust us by repeating all the sentences every time He gives an instruction. So it's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to what we call ijaz. Precise, to the point. It says you know it already, what we mean. It is so honorable that everybody knows what we mean when you believe. Yeah? Or you who believe. The first one, لا تقدموا. The first instruction, the relationship with Allah. How to engage with Allah, how to deal with Allah, how to behave with Allah. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. Don't ever put your wishful thinking, put your dream, put your imagination, put your opinions when Allah reveals the ayah, when Allah decides something, when Allah gives something. It's not up to you to come and say, but no. Don't ever advance yourself. It's a human nature to give your opinion. It's a human nature to give your advice. It's human nature to suggest ideas. But not, we have to have a life. This is Islam, brothers. This is revelation. This is Quran and Sunnah. This is Quran and Sunnah. We hear and obey. سَمِعْنَا وَطَعْنَا. This is the character of the believer. You hear the opinion, you hear the command, you obey. لَا تُقَدِّمُ بَيْنَ يَدِي الرَّحْمَ وَصُورِهِ. So the first ayah in the Quran. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fear Allah. Have conscience of Allah. Know about Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Allah hears everything you say. And if what you say is not what's in your heart, He's also alim. He knows everything. He knows everything. He hears everything you say. He knows everything you do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us say that which is please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do that which make us closer to Him. Next one, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. So Allah is teaching us how to engage with Allah, how to behave with Allah. And then the second one, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. La tarfa'u aswatakum fawqa sawti an-nabi. Don't ever raise your voice in the presence of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at that. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. First one, and there is no end. It's like, oh no, it's so beautiful. It just straight away it grabs our attention again into the same command, the same statement, the same instruction. Don't raise your voice in the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of course, knowing the reason for the revelation is very important for us to understand. This ayah was revealed when two Sahaba raised their voice with each other in the presence of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this ayah was revealed. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. It did not, look at this, it did not embarrass them. It did not expose them. It did not call them by name. Yo, why do you do it? No. So if you see somebody in the masjid doing something wrong, don't just expose them in front of everybody. Hey, yo, what is wrong with it? No. If you have to talk, talk generally. Brothers, somebody did this and this, please look after that. You know, and make it general. Don't embarrass and hurt the feelings of anybody. Learn from the Quran. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, who believe, don't raise your voice in the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the danger? أَن تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. All your deeds will be wiped out. When you have no respect for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you have no respect for the Sunnah, and we seek protection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's happening nowadays. So many people nowadays just attack messengers and prophets and attack God himself all the time. So we ask Allah to protect us from deviation. It wipes out all good deeds. Allah says, وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. They don't even know that. They don't even recognize that mocking or ridiculing or making fun of prophets in general or God or religions can destroy any good deed, any kindness, any act of generosity they can do in this life. They will find zero on akhir. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And they don't even realize or recognize that. And this, لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ, as we said last week, don't raise your voice, it was said when the tribe came to visit in the 9th year of Hijrah, 2 years before the Passover of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the tribe started to come to Islam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to appoint a leader for every tribe, for the delegation. And the Sahaba differed. Do they ask Al-Qa'id? Taqab Naam, or they ask Harith ibn Thabit, who can be the leader? They differ, just normal. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching them manners. You are the best of mankind. You are the best generation. You don't have absolutely no room for errors here because you are a role model for humanity to come. You know, in Surah Al-Anfal, Allah says, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ. They ask you about, you know, the rulings on all the booties of the war. And the answer came 40 ayahs. Not straight away. 40 ayahs of good manners. First. Not you should ask about this material world. Not you should ask about this. And then at the end it says in Al-Fali Billah Rasul. So similarly here, Allah is teaching them good manners with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Applies to us too. Because any one of us who have or he hears the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, it's as if the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is there, present with them. The scholars say, if you have the book of hadith at home, as if you have the Prophet with you at home. You don't need the Prophet physically to be sitting there, because Allah have preserved his sunnah. Allah have protected his life as an example for us. So, to not never ever to raise our voice or to raise our opinion against the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And amazing, the ayah says, لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي. The Arab understand that don't raise your voice above the voice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It means you are allowed to raise your voice, but not more than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's voice. But what they did, Abu Bakr went to the Prophet ﷺ and told him, O Messenger, from now on, I will just whisper to you. He will only whisper. He would never. The ayah says, "Don't raise your voice above his voice." And so they are allowed to speak, but that is how they understood. That's how they adhere to the ayah. That's how they apply it straight away to the level of absolutely silent. He will just wave now. How things are work. He's not talking. Same with Umar. Umar, that he, when he speak, the whole masjid will shake. After this ayah was revealed, the Prophet have to tell him, what did he say? Raise your voice, I can't hear. After this ayah was revealed. This is the attitude towards the Quran and the Sunnah, subhanAllah. So لا ترفع أصواتكم, don't raise your voice, because the punishment is severe. Disrespect to the Prophet Muhammad is major. Is major, major sin. Allah says it wipes out all the good deeds. It wipes out all the good deeds. So those who say, give it to me from the Quran only. Just give me the Quran ayah. Where is in the Quran that says that pornography is haram? Where is in the Quran that says that the smoke is haram? These people is like the very ignorant person who came to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Very, you know, just came, he never knew nothing about the deen. And he says, Allahumma arhamni wa Muhammad faqa. Oh Allah, have mercy on me and Muhammad. And that's it, nobody else. So the Prophet said, you've narrowed something very vast. The mercy of Allah is massive. You can't just narrow it to two. And the knowledge of the deen also, you can't just narrow it to the Quran. Because the Quran and the Sunnah and the understanding of the Sahaba is preserved by Allah as the deen of Islam. So, it's a warning for me and you never ever to cross the line with the respect to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sunnah. If that is the punishment for those who raise their voice, straight away the ayah comes and says the reward for those who lower their voice, as if it's a, you know, appreciating Abu Bakr's what, you know, action. The ayah straight after it says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَغُضُّونَ أَصْوَاتَهُمْ. Yeah? Those who lower their voice at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عند رسول الله أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ امْتَحَنَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِلتَّقْوَى. Those who lower their voice in the presence of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with respect and love, these are the people who Allah tested the heart. He put them through the test. Why? To achieve the taqwa. To gain the taqwa, to display it, to show it, to teach it to every mankind afterwards. And the scholars say this ayah was revealed in Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. What is the reward for them? Those who lower their voice and respect and love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. The forgiveness for them and the reward is massive, is huge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah tested their heart to bring piety in it. How do we achieve taqwa? From this ayah. From this ayah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَغُضُّونَ أَصْوَاتَهُمْ عِنْدَ رَسُولِنَا. Those who respect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ امْتَحَنَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ. Those achieve taqwa. So to achieve taqwa, you obey Allah. Obey Allah through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You obey Allah, you know, by adhering to the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the ayah just keep teaching us. As for those, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Any one of us, if we, alhamdulillah, we did not live at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't ever say, I wish I was at the time of the Prophet, I would have been like Abu Bakr and Umar. No, maybe you would have been like Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. So thank Allah that you did not exist at that time. Allah chose us to be at this time, so make use of it now. Because look at this. One of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are companions. All companions are great people. And for us, we are all of them, 100% of them, are the people of Jannah, chosen by Allah. Allah scanned their heart and chose them. We have, Allah saved us from being there with them. So we need to save ourselves from criticizing them. We need to control the tongue from talking about them. Their affairs with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah? Because this is Allah's choice. Allah have always chose the disciples around the messengers to be the best of people. Every messenger and every ummah, every community in the world, they love, revere, respect the disciples of their messenger absolutely to the degree that unimaginable. We the Muslims should pass that. We the Muslims should also love and respect and make dua and ask Allah to gather us with them, the companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of them, all of them. So in this ayah Allah says, the tribes that come, you know, tribes coming in horses and camels and donkeys in the desert, weeks in the desert to see the Prophet. Can you imagine the excitement? Hey, I just can't imagine. We, if we go to Hajj to see the grave, we're so excited, we'll be like flying. Some of us, some people lose it, and when they're around the grave, they touch and kiss the grave. They lose the feel, you know, they go wild. It happened in the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they are excused, they are, you know, the feeling, they can't control it. They come in traveling to see that messenger, to see that leader, and they arrive at night. But they just, so they can't sleep. So they call out from outside. Ya Muhammad! Akhraj ya Muhammad! Come out, you know, we need to give you the allegiance. We need to become Muslim. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's just so nice, so gentle, so thin, you just can't imagine, you know, the absolutely beautiful manners of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He'll be working all day, all night, dealing and traveling and leading, and he still has to go out and meet, so he never said to them anything. He never said to them, don't call, or I have, you know, this is my sleep time, or this is my family time. He never ever said that. People used to come to his house when he said, come for dinner. They used to go and wait till the dinner is cooked and sit down. And he needs to meet people. He will leave the visitor sitting there and he goes and meet people and come and they're still sitting. And he won't tell them, you know, come for dinner, it means 6 o'clock, not from 2 o'clock in the afternoon. But he could not say it. Allah said it in the Quran. Allah said it to them. If you are invited for food, only come when it is ready. Once you eat, if you eat, finish, go. Because the Prophet ﷺ was just so highly, you know, polite and kind. He never said anything. He didn't say anything to these people. Allah says it to teach us all. Allah says, those who call you, at, you know, in the middle of the night, loudly, you know, they're wild. They just have lost control. أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. What is their mind? وَلَمْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا. If they waited, if they had some patience, till you get out, you know, you go out normally for Fajr or something and they will see you, it was good for them. It's better for them to wait. But look, وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah is all forgiving. He forgives them. Allah has had mercy on them. Compare this one with the previous ayah. Allah says, don't raise your voice. You lose your good deed. Why? Because he's talking to the Sahaba. These are the elite, these are the leaders. These are not just somebody who just come to Islam. You are the role model. You get big warning. But for those who don't know, we need to be gentle and kind with them. This should apply to our life. Somebody come to Islam, we can't just give them Islam in 1 week. We have to be kind and gentle and easy with them. You know, somebody who's just young, we need also to be the same, kind and gentle and easy with them. We can't just strictly, you know, want everybody to be like us suddenly. No, we did not just born like that. We had all these years to develop and learn and to gain experience. look at how the surah is going. How to deal with Allah, how to deal with the messenger, how to have manners around him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then for the new visitors, those who come, how to deal with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then it moves as a community as a whole. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Also, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. And there is no end. All are instruction, just joining together. O you who believe, إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. If someone comes to the community, and trying to spread rumor, trying to say something happened. Have you seen this article? Have you seen so and so? He's saying this and that. You don't just react. Look at Allah's teaching for us. We don't just react. We don't just say everything we think. فَتَبَيَّنُوا. Make sure that what they are saying is true. Find out the proofs and evidence for what they are saying first. فَتَبَيَّنُوا. Yeah? This ayah was revealed. There's a reason for revelation and there is a generic use of the ayah. The reason for the revelation, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so many tribes came to Islam in this year. New one. And Islam is salah and zakah and fasting and hajj. So straight away when the zakah is due, he will send people to collect the zakah for them to teach them. So one person went to get the zakah from one tribe. When he gone there, he found the tribes ready for war. The tribes have, you know, arming themselves. And this person who's collecting the zakah had previous conflicts before Islam, tribal lifestyle. So he was so worried, so scared for his own life. When he saw what's going on, he just turned around and rushed back to the Medina. Not only that he rushed back and made up a story. He was so embarrassed, he made up a story. He said, oh, I found them getting ready for fight. They refused to give the zakah. I think they're coming to fight us. So the ayah came down and says, if anybody comes and says something, just make sure before you move your armies and you give orders to, you know, this is our enemy, make sure that the news and the facts, it matches what he said. Why? أَن تُصِيمُ قَوْمًا بِجَهَالٍ. That you may hurt somebody unknowingly. Somebody, anybody. It did not say Muslim, it did not say Sahabi, it did not say, I don't know. قَوْمًا. You know, indefinite. Anybody can get hurt unknowingly, you will regret it. فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. This is an instruction for us how to deal with the, as they say, the current affairs. We can't just react to an article in the paper. We can't react to somebody saying anything. Yeah? We need to sit and think and refer to our leaders and discuss and get opinions and then come out with our solutions. Don't just react individually or at the community level. When the Muslims were really angry for what this man is saying and they're getting hyped up, the leader of this tribe came over with the zakah and he says, we're waiting for somebody to come and collect the zakah. Nobody came. We got worried. Nobody came to take the zakah from us. وَعْلَمُوا, the ayah carries on and says, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. So don't just react because you have, remember, so Allah is telling the Sahaba, remember, the messenger is with you. The messenger is there. Don't just react and go, you know, on what you hear. The messenger is there. Where is the messenger now? Is the messenger there? Well, yes, of course. We have the messenger. All these books is documented by every reaction, every decision, everything he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are very fortunate, we are very blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have that in our hand. So we always need to refer back to how would the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam react to this? How would the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam deal with this? What did the Sahaba do in this situation, What's in the, yeah? So that is how we need to refer to the scholars, and that's how the scholar gets their opinion for us. And we need to know that Allah says, لَوْ يُطِعْكُمْ فِي كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ عَلَيْتُمْ. If the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would just obey and follows what everybody wants, it will be a very difficult religion. It will become a very difficult religion for anybody to practice it. That's why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never gave decision like that. He waited for revelation. He waited for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to say, this is the decision how to make it. This is the decision how to make it. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانِ. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that turns your heart into iman. Turn your heart to love iman, to love good deeds. وكان رأي منكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that makes us dislikes bad deed, dislikes obedience, dislikes, you know, disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not up to me or you. The heart is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you like to pray on time, if you like to share your knowledge and your time and your helping, and you like to visit the needy or the sick or the poor, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's favor on you. It's Allah's favor on you. And Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ. These are the truly success, those are the truly successful ones. Who are the successful? Those who love obedience, who love iman, who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. This is success. And dislike and detest all the disobedience acts, all the what we call fusuq, doing sins openly, regularly. Allah dislike that, and we should dislike that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our iman. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واصرافنا في امرنا وثبت اقدامنا وانصرنا على اعدائنا. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك واكرمنا بكرمك. اللهم احفظ اولادنا واولاد المسلمين. اللهم احفظ اولادنا واولاد المسلمين. اللهم احفظ اولادنا واولاد المسلمين. اللهم فرج كرباتنا وكربات المسلمين. اللهم ارفع الهم والغم عنا وعن المسلمين. اللهم اشف امراضنا وامراض المسلمين. اللهم اشف امراضنا وامراض المسلمين. اللهم اشف امراضنا وامراض المسلمين. اللهم ارحم امواتنا واموات المسلمين. اللهم انا نسالك حسن الخاتمه. اللهم نسالك حسن الخاتمه. اللهم نسالك حسن الخاتمه. الحمد لله رب العالمين.